SCP-173 is an anomalous concrete statue that always appears to be in the exact same position, standing upright with its hands facing forward. But what if we tried to forcefully change SCP-173's position, for example by knocking it over? And what if we pushed the statue down a flight of stairs? Would it break? In this video, we try to answer these questions. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel with notifications on, so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. And we plan on exploring more interesting SCP-173 experiments like this one in the future. To begin with, the idea of defeating SCP-173 by knocking it over or pushing it down a flight of stairs is quite popular, and because of this, there are quite a lot of theories about what will happen, most of which are quite funny to imagine. For example, that SCP-173 will break into hundreds of small pieces of concrete that will all move about and crunch people's necks, essentially creating an army of small SCP-173s. Or that the statue will survive the fall, get back up when it's not observed, and become angry and more aggressive as a result. Some people even believe that if SCP-173 breaks, the concrete dust that would form would begin moving at fast speeds when it's not observed, and would find other ways to attack people, for example by blocking people's lungs. As we said, all very funny scenarios. There is even an unofficial experiment log on Reddit that discusses this exact scenario, the same one which also discussed the SCP-173 piggyback idea. In the log, a few scientists decide they want to learn more about the way the statue functions, so they instruct a D-class to try and gently rotate SCP-173 in an attempt to change the way it is facing. In the meantime, the statue is under constant observation by three other prisoners in order to prevent it from attacking anyone. The D-class enters the containment chamber, grabs SCP-173 by its shoulders and proceeds to rotate it while complaining of it being heavy and cold. And, of course, this isn't a surprise, given the statue's size and physical composition. Due to the fact that the D-class successfully rotated the statue, the scientists concluded that SCP-173 can only manifest a reaction to the environment around it when it's not observed. But they were not fully satisfied with the results, so they instructed the D-class to try and gently push SCP-173 in an attempt to topple it over. The prisoner enters, places his hands over the statue's chest, and begins to apply light force. After approximately 2 seconds of force applied, the D-class says that 173 is too heavy and that he needs to push harder. He is then given the go-ahead to apply more pressure, and after approximately 5 seconds of pushing, SCP-173 starts to slowly topple over backwards, at which point the prisoner is told to stop and let go of the object. The statue then returns to its fully upright position. In the end, the scientists conclude that 173 is a lot heavier than a concrete statue of its size should be, and they decide to be cautious this time around and refrain from pushing SCP-173 over. But this isn't the only document that discusses something like this, because there's an SCP tale that showcases an even funnier way of making the statue fall on the ground, using a banana peel. In this tale, a scientist called Dr. Henderson must be terminated because he has been exposed to an info hazard that will turn him into a monster within a few days. But rather than the standard protocol, the doctor asks to be eliminated by SCP-173. And although such things aren't usually allowed in the agency, permission was granted because of Dr. Henderson's 37 years of loyal service. Henderson gets ready to enter SCP-173's containment chamber, together with a D-class, but the scientist is carrying a box. When the prisoner asks about what's inside, the doctor says that there's something he has always wondered. They both enter, and right away, Henderson tells the D-class he can close his eyes and give them some rest, claiming that he will keep an eye on the statue in the meantime. The prisoner complies, and Henderson decides to get his own termination over with. Before the prisoner has time to open his eyes, Anderson blinks, but right after he overturns a box of banana peels at 173's feet. In a fraction of a second, Anderson's eyes open, and SCP-173 is seen face down on the floor on the other side of the cell. "Now I can go in peace," says Henderson before he closes his eyes once again. The last thing he feels is a slab of concrete slapping him 27 times. So as we see, this tale is very interesting, but it becomes apparent that although technically canon, this SCP tale isn't meant to be taken seriously. Nonetheless, the first experiment log we discussed, the one about pushing SCP-173 over, seemed reasonable, but we must not forget that this log is posted on Reddit, not on the official wiki, so it's not canon. Furthermore, this is the same log which we discussed in our Stand On 173 video, and if you saw that video, you would know that this experiment log ended up being wrong. To begin with, we have to mention a very common misconception about the statue which we debunked in our SCP-173 piggyback video, namely the fact that 173 doesn't make physical contact with its victims when it crunches their necks. We won't explain why, because we discussed this in detail in that video, but in short, this is because SCP-173 is capable of telekinesis, so basically, the statue crunches people's necks using magic. But why is this so important for the knockover SCP-173 experiment? Well, telekinesis is the ability to exert force on physical objects without any direct contact. This means that a part of crunching people's necks without touching them, SCP-173 should also be capable of holding onto the walls of its containment chamber. So even though the statue has small legs that would normally make it very unstable, the statue shouldn't be able to fall over because it can prevent itself from falling by pushing against the walls using telekinesis. This idea is also supported by the fact that SCP-173 moves at a very rapid speed when it's not being watched and stops instantaneously once you open your eyes. If the statue moved so fast and stopped its movement using only its feet, it would most definitely fall over every time, but instead, this doesn't happen because of this ability. So does this mean that SCP-173 can't possibly fall over because it's always supporting itself anomalously? Well, not necessarily, because we have to consider something else. SCP-173 can't attack people when it's being observed, meaning that watching the statue temporarily disables its telekinesis, because if it didn't, 173 would be more than happy to move about and attack people all the time. So if under observation, the statue can't use its telekinesis to crunch people, then it shouldn't be able to use this ability to support itself as well. This means that we should definitely be capable of knocking SCP-173 over, as long as we are watching it. Of course, when out of sight, the statue will use its powers to get back up, but nonetheless, we now know that SCP-173 can be knocked over. But what if we pushed the statue down a flight of stairs? Would SCP-173 break? On first glance, SCP-173 should easily break if we chuck it down a flight of stairs, because it's made of concrete and rebar, and the force necessary in order to break such an object isn't all that high. And a lot of you are going to think of the tale SCP-173-D, where the statue is allegedly destroyed using a sledgehammer. However, I don't consider this tale to be canon, because the statue is still alive according to the main SCP-173 article. So in my opinion, this tale is nothing more than eye candy that's made to satisfy the people who want to see the alleged termination of the statue. And let's be real, 173 is anomalous, so it's likely a lot more durable than ordinary concrete. After all, the statue successfully fought off SCP-682, which as we know is one of the most powerful creatures in the wiki. And during this battle, the reptile tried to destroy the statue by hitting it with its powerful clawed appendages, but as we know, SCP-173 came out totally unscathed. Also, it's unlikely that 173 would break in this scenario, because the statue's creators made it very durable. As we discussed in our What is SCP-173 video, the statue was brought to life using a complex ritual by an SCP group of interest with the goal of making an art piece that eliminates as many people as possible. And it's very unlikely that SCP-173's creators would make their pride and joy so vulnerable to destruction. Instead, using anomalous means, the statue is likely made to be very durable or even indestructible, so if we chuck it down a flight of stairs, 173 will most likely bounce down the stairs, fall on the ground and get back up using its powers as soon as it's not observed. And to be honest, thank God it won't break, because even though the statue is very dangerous, an army of concrete debris that crunch people's necks sounds even worse. So what do you think? Could we push SCP-173 over? And if the statue were to break, would the concrete chunks begin attacking people as well? Let us know in the comments. Please leave a like if you enjoyed, and subscribe as we will be exploring more interesting SCP-173 experiments in the future.